Hey guys, and welcome to my 11th episode of my MTG Free to Play series. So in this episode we're going to be doing another quick draft. I did debate about just doing my 4 daily wins today and then just being done with it and waiting till Tuesday to post my next video, but I actually feel like drafting again, so I'm going to do another quick draft here. And let's get started. Well, actually, before that, let's open packs. Always open packs. Alright, so we did get some pretty good rares here. You get Elite Spellbinder, which is a really great 3-drop, 3-1 flying. Lightning Bolt is also great in this format. You also have Pop Quiz, Masterpiece. This is a really good pack. I think I'm going to take the Spellbinder here, though. Normally, I would take Lightning Bolt, but seeing as it's not legal and historic, maybe it's not worth. So yeah, I'm just going to take the Elite Spellbinder, because I could also use that in Constructed as well. Alright, so I could follow it up with a Combat Professor. Ingenious Inspiration is also really good. Got Memory Lamps and Barium Books also. I think here I'll take the removal. It's between Inspiration and Combat Professor for me. I'm not too sure. This leaves me open to Silver Coil, but I already passed a Lightning Bolt, which is really good. Rare and red. So maybe I am taking Ingenious Inspiration. It also goes to the face, which I like. Okay, here the pick isn't quite as clear. Let's see, I could go Zoomancy here for the safe pick. It's the best card in the pack, I believe. Kelpie Guide's okay. Defiant Strike is good. I think here I'll take a Kelpie Guide and see where it goes from here. Alright, so there's the Lorehold Pledge Mage here if I really want to go into Lorehold. Decisive Denial is the best card in the pack. Or Demigod Woe Eater's pretty close. But I'm far away from playing either of these. So I think here I just go Pledge Mage. Alright, I got some solid choices here. I have Enthusiastic Study Break. Spirit is okay, but I think I'm going to take this Study Break just to get an early learn. Okay, I could take Star Pupil here. I could also take Pop Quiz. In case I hedge that way. Sideboard as well. Alright, here I'm going to take the summonings for my sideboard. Alright, so I already have two learn. I think here maybe I just need a good 2-drop. Okay, like academic dispute makes them block pretty terribly. Could take the campus here, but I have been seeing a lot of Loro campuses. Maybe I get one wheeled. Okay, this is not the best pledge mage out of the cycle, but I guess I'll take a second one. I think it might be better than Make Your Mark here. Or maybe Thrilling Discovery might be, but I feel like I could get that later if I really want it. Okay, good Blood Age General here. Here I could take the Discovery. Actually, seeing how I'm pretty low curve, maybe the mascot interception might be good. One red, take over their fractal. Kinda like that. Might actually play that. Okay, Swords to Plowshare. Got Flunk if we want to splash. Curve if we want to splash that. I think we're going to just take the swords here. It's not really a constructed playable card because it's banned and everything, just like the Lightning Bolt was, but there's no other enticing cards that I want to get here. Okay, here I could take a Pilgrim of the Ages. I do like to have at least one or two in my lore hole decks. I could also take the Pledge Mage here, but I think here is an easy Pilgrim. Alright, this is easy heated debate. Nothing else really comes close in power level. Maybe Mortality Spear, but not in our colors. Oh wow. This is a fourth pick Crackle with power. That's insane. Okay, so we're a pretty aggressive deck, and then we have like an insane top end to finish things off. Okay, I'm gonna get a rip apart here. It's pretty easy rip apart for us. Versatile removal is always good. Okay, I could take the start from scratch. I do need more things to pick off from the sideboard here, but maybe getting my first campus is better. Tome Shredder is also a really good aggressive card. Let's see, how much learn do I have? One, two. I suppose probably not gonna play the Shaman. Or I could get Tome Shredder. It might synergize with things I pick up later. Alright, so I could see myself taking this land here. I think I'm gonna take the 4-drop here. It's just a good way to get one of my removals back. Maybe do a second Crackle of Power if it gets there. I really want to be super aggressive though, so maybe taking the Spirit here might be better. I think I'll just take the Warden for now and see where it goes. Okay, so I do have a hall monitor. I could get, I'm probably taking it. Otherwise, I would just be picking up a thrilling discovery. Not something I want to do right now. Okay, I'll take a lash. I'm not sure what that was doing there. Okay, interesting pick now. I have Pledge Mage for the double red. I think I will take that. Looks like I'm lightly touching white. Awesome, another two drop. Alright, so our rare here, Pestilent Cauldron, and Restorative Burst. Not in our colors. We have a choice of Ingenious Inspiration or another Heated Debate. I think I'm going to take the Heated Debate here. Do already have a few learn, but not a lot of targets for that. And having something uncounterable is going to be really good. There's a lot of counter spells running around in this format. Okay, here I think I'll take another Elemental Summonings for the sideboard. Hopefully wheeling a Effigy or a Historian. Wow. Okay, a third Heated Debate. I'll take as many of these as I can. I don't mind a Guiding Voice as well, but I'll take all these removal spells when I could get them. Wow. Okay, so there's Shock and Return Pass Caller. I think I will take the Pass Caller here. Actually, let's see here. We got that with so many book cards being so good. Okay, so creature wise, we're doing pretty well. I think maybe I will take the Pass Caller here. I have so many good removal spells to get. Maybe if I had better two drops, I would be more inclined to take the shock. Let's see. We'll take a Guiding Voice here now. Do have a chance to pick up a Show Confidence now. Still only have two summonings to get though. I do want a removal spell I could get out of the board. Now that I have one, two, three, four ways. Convince myself there. take a 3-3 for 3. Oh, wow. Variant books. Duration. Let's see, I suppose I'll take a... Shoot another intro, I guess. You don't want any of those. I'm not going to play any of those. I might play Thrilling Discovery. Might play an assistant, just get a really good get all my spells back deck. Here, I'll take another warden, start from scratch. Oh wow, another guiding voice. I just want to spread out my lessons now. Wow, do I want another 2-drop or do I want... I'll take a 2-drop or draw spell. I have to discard 2 cards for this. I don't like that. I'll take the creature instead. Alright guys, so this is the deck I ended up building. It's a fairly aggressive low to the ground, mostly 1s, 2s, and 3s. We got a few 4-drops here. Got a 6-drop right here. Sixteen lands in this deck, so fairly aggressive. So let's try out. I might make some changes. I do have a more 4s I could put in, just to make the deck last a little longer, I guess. I'm not too sure if that's right. Or to just give it more longevity throughout the games, but I don't feel like it needs it. I think this is going to be fairly aggressive how it is, and let's go into the games. Alright. Really good hand. Hopefully I draw some more creatures, but other than that, it's perfect. Let's see, I could get rid of it now. Not entirely sure if that's worth it, though. Yeah, I suppose I'll just get rid of it now so it doesn't get value. It's gonna gain a bunch of life. I need to start drawing a lot of land though. I'll grow my Tome Shredder. I don't need to, but just to give it more oomph. Right now that they're doing this, I could Guiding Voice, get the start from scratch, kill the Eye Twitch. Alright, they need another island to cast that. Yeah, I think I just attack, they'll double block something, they kill the Diane. Actually, I decided not to attack with the Tome Shredder because I could get bigger where it doesn't even matter. Actually, let's do that. I feel like I want the Guiding Voice now. Instead of the swords. I can't attack at the moment, but that's alright. Like they didn't draw a removal. That's why I put it on the Pledge Mage. In case they did, they would have to kill the Pledge Mage instead of my Pass Caller to get the value. I just know his opponent's name, Mittens McKitten. That's hilarious. Okay, so not sure if this helps them too much. They don't even gain the life because they exile the past. Even if it doesn't and they pump. I still go in for the win. Good games, opponent. So pretty sweet hand. Don't have any red, but we don't have any red spells. Now I need red mana, but let's see what the opponent's working with. Immortality Spear. Yeah, get rid of their spear. Okay, now that I was gonna say that pretty much means he's gonna be playing his Drake, but it doesn't seem to be the case. Still want to hold on to this guiding voice. Not too sure how I want to use it yet. So, I don't want to get elemental summoning because that's super far away from me playing that. I guess it gets intro to annihilation. That's gross. I will play a plains and no tax. Start getting in some damage, I suppose. Wow, I would have thought he would block since he didn't attack with it last turn. hang back. That's really aggressive with my opponent, but that's okay with me. There we go. Nothing to get back that's relevant. I'll just play Warden. I really need to draw a second red source. Oof. Good game, opponent. So I am on the play. If I draw another land, that's going to be so much gas. So let's keep. Hello. Alright. This lets me curve out perfectly now. I was gonna say I might not even block because of how aggressive my hand is turning out to be. Especially if they don't play another 2 drop. Yeah. I'm confident in this race with my kind of hand. That's fine with me too. Wow, they have a closing statement, maybe? Alright. Hopefully they don't have Professor's Warning, because this was really gonna get us if they do. Alright. Although I should have known since they weren't getting priority. Maybe I should have attacked to see. Check if they got priority, but it's a little too deep for a quick draft. I do want to win though. back here. Oh, closing statement, guiding voice. Closing statement. Let's see, do I want to kill either of those? No, I think I'll just take my draw. If he uses closing statement on either of these, I'm fine. I'll just kill whoever he pumps. That's a nice draw. Let's see. One more mana and I could do it for two. Right, so 5, 8 mana. It's for two. So I think maybe what I want to do now is... let's attack first and see what they do. So I'll play the Mentor and kill their blocker. Returns it to my hand. Actually, maybe I do want to do that because now I get to scry. It all comes down to my next draw step to see if I draw a land or not. Hopefully they don't gain life. Alright. Hopefully they don't have a way to gain 2 life, but what a game. Amazing game, good games opponent. Okay, fine hand to keep. One more land unlocks the deck basically, so let's go ahead and keep. Alright, so that was a little, nice little exchange. Losses learn. I think here I heated debate. Let's see, I should probably use up all my mana now. And just get in for some damage, I suppose. Not too sure what to do here. I suppose I'll just use it now. And I'll get a start from scratch because there's no guarantee I'm gonna get a second mountain. That's a good one. See, I guess I should attack first and see what happens. God, I just want to play a creature, but I think I have to get rid of this. It stops my entire deck. Let's see what's going up on top. Nothing really to stop my flyer, but I'm gonna get rid of their card advantage. Interesting with the no blocks there. Third heated debate here. I think I'm gonna play the Pledge Mage here. Maybe force one of them to block into my Pledge Mage. So opponent has something they could play for 2 mana. I'm guessing it's the Learn. Yeah, hopefully that entices him to attack. excuse me. Opponent pondering right here. I think he does have Arcane Subtraction, or let's see what else. It could be the 2-mana pump. Opponent wisely not attacking with this unblockable creature. I didn't want to jump since I drew a 3/3. Let's see. I guess I could take it slow. Now I could attack with everything. Opponent's gonna have a really hard time getting good blocks in since everything dies. To show it off. Slower than most hands, but I think this will be okay. Help me at all, really. All right, didn't play anything interesting. Maybe now he's debating about getting rid of my pilgrim. Blank likes his hand, though. He likes his hand. Play the warding because he can block. We're not in an aggressive position here. Play our own. Play Tome Shredder. I think maybe playing our own might hold them back from attacking finally. And then next turn we could dispute and heated debate something. See how aggressive do we want to be here? All right, let's see if we can trade creatures here. A good trade for me. Alright, so that's what he was holding up. Alright, so opponent is playing out his entire hand, which is good for us. So we're at a stalemate again. just want to keep the pressure going. Okay, it's a good thing he's waiting and making these small. I'm at the point where I can start doing this in one turn. But I think I just want another 4 drop out. It's going deep in the in his deck right here. Or seems like it. So we just gotta wait until we start drawing some action here. That's bad for us. See what he gets. Alright, let's see if we'll turn this out. Good game's opponent. Alright, so this is a pretty good hand. Very aggressive curve. Got 2 into 3. Gonna wait into playing the elite. I just wanna wait for them to like draw the good stuff, if you know what I mean. I think here I do, now that I feel like they're gonna play a spell. Eliminate for 4 mana. Yeah, I'm fine getting rid of the closing statement here. I don't care about those other cards. Here. Maybe I just crackle this guy. Normally it's a finisher card, but I think this is fine. Otherwise I just want to play these two cards and see what happens. I'll get greedy and save my crackle power. Just in the off chance they don't attack, you know. Okay, here I do just crackle now. Honestly, here I'm just better off taking Ingenious Inspiration. Don't mind another crackle though. I'll just take the crackle. Thank you. can still play this perfect. Now I just need one land and Crackle kills him. Unfortunate. What if I crackle, kill the laureate, swing with everything? I think I'll do that. Laureate lives. All right, no attacks. Stop me, stop me. Yeah, I think I'm fine with that team too. I think I should have blocked with my other guy, but that's fine. Decides to handle this because I get to kill, shoot him for 10, shoot something of his for 10. Just in case it doesn't work out. Alright, good games on it. Alright, this is a bit too risky to keep, so I'm gonna mulligan. I have pretty expensive stuff, but I guess I'll keep this. Let's put back the Crackle power. Maybe I have a way to shuffle my deck. so opponent playing Gruul. Played his first cheap big guy. I don't mind racing him back. As him being in Gruul, he probably has a million pump spells. That was a good draw for me. So that worked out for us. Getting no blocks. Take a more defensive position. This is where a pump spell really destroys us right now. Because I'm going to have to go for the double block, but it worked out great for us. Nothing here to really get. I think I will pass Caller here and do the same play with my Lorehold Pledge Mage. So next turn, my plan is to Guiding Voice the Pledge Mage, dispute the Symmetris, okay, this doesn't change my play much. Oh, I could not do a lot though. Next turn, I guess I'll just Annihilation. Did I shuffle? I did shuffle my deck with Pilgrim. Alright, so I have a Crackle to get as well. Chomper here. That's a good combo. Still have Annihilation up. Get one more or two. Interesting that our opponent's straight Gruul. Good one. Don't want to give my opponent more cards at the moment, but my opponent will think he's safe. Okay, I'm slowly getting him down to 10 life. That's where I want him. Yeah, that's good. I don't want to combine if I don't have to. Attack with a pledge mage and see what they do. Shoot them for three. Okay.
get Annihilation, see what they do now. I want to show them Annihilation just so they could play a little scared. Hopefully they make a mistake where they otherwise wouldn't if they had no fear. Yeah, like that. Jumping mood. Well, that's a good one. So he can't attack with the colony, because then he's just dead. He had the big play. Oh, second colony saved him. Yeah, I think I just came back. I need something to push through these colonies without dying on the way back. I already got an answer here. Don't believe I drafted any other way to get rid of something like that. I made a mistake there. I should have taken a 3 extra damage. Oops, oops, oops. Play it. played a little too scared that last turn. Alright, that does it. Good games, opponent. Alright guys, so we went 4-3 for this quick draft for number 11. Not too bad. We did get a pretty aggressive Lorehold deck, I suppose. I did want more 2-drops and more 3-drops, but we just ended up picking up so much removal. Had 3 Heated Debate, Genius Inspiration, got Rip Apart, which I don't think I only saw once. Swords. Academic Dispute is basically a removal spell. So is Crackle. I did use Crackle as a removal spell. So I had tons and tons of removal spell. I just didn't get there. Maybe I was supposed to play 17. There was some spots where I felt like I needed mana. Dual Lands would have definitely helped at that point. I think the awkwardness of our non-existent top end was what got us, because we didn't end. I mean, we are an aggressive deck, but we're not too aggressive since it's mainly like removal spells. So I felt like once the game progressed long enough, our opponent just had bigger, stronger cards to be playing than us. Like we were playing like 3-drops and 2-drops on turn 7 and 8. So, yeah, I had really fun. I do like playing Lorehold. It's a pretty fun, aggressive deck. And I hope to catch you guys in the next draft.